Well, aren't you just a bad, bad USB? Oh, that is a terrible intro. Hello and welcome to Modern Broadcast. We are back at it again with our Flipper Zero here. This time we're going to be tackling probably one of the most powerful and honestly one of the most misunderstood features of the Flipper, and that is bad USB. So, whether you're brand new, curious about what bad USB can do, in this video I'm going to walk you through what it is, how you can use it, how you can write your own scripts, and the big red flag, how not to use it. But first, a quick thank you from today's sponsor, PCB Way. That's right, I still have this sign. I'm pretty sure it's a sticker. It's definitely a sticker. PCB Way is your one-stop shop to bring all your ideas and creations to life, whether you're doing prototyping or full assembly. PCB Way has you covered. They also do this gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous 3D printing here. Just look at our Flipper Zero shell here. So transparent, so green, so maybe broken. Whether you're a hobbyist or building a serious hardware, they've got fast turnaround, durable products, great prices, and top-notch customer service. So if you got an idea and need a board, check them out, PCBWay.com. Big thanks to PCB Way for supporting the channel. Go ahead and get on with the content, huh? All right, so let's break it down. Bad USB is a feature on the Flipper Zero that lets it act. Now, you may be thinking, all right, cool, but I already got a keyboard. Well, that may be true.
Is that the boy? The boy! It's the boy!
It's the boy!
My son! Oh, right in the mouth. Right in the mouth.
Oh, okay. All right, calm down. Wait, easy. Okay, there you go. All right, and he's gone. So how exactly do you get bad USB set up? For that, we're going to need our computer. Let's go ahead, swap on over. So here we are at our computer, and the first thing that we're going to have to do is get QFlipper installed over on our computer. So we're going to go ahead and download QFlipper and start the install process. Okay, and finish. It says to connect our Flippers. We're going to go ahead and do that now. All right, now that we have our Flipper Zero plugged in, what we're going to want to do is click on this little icon here for the file manager, SD card, and we see over here we have a folder called bad USB. We're going to open that up, and this is where you'll store all of your payloads, which are small text files written in Ducky Script, which we'll cover in just a moment. Now, if you want to download ready-to-use payloads, I highly recommend checking out I Am Jacoby's bad USB GitHub, where there is a ton of different payloads to choose from, and most of which are safe for beginners. Now, before you go and download 100 different scripts and payloads, always review the code before you run it. I'm always shocked at how many people just download something off the internet and then run it on their systems. You have no idea what it's doing. Always review the code first. It is also important to not use bad USB on systems you do not have permission to run them on. That can get you into some trouble. It might seem like a harmless prank. However, most places, unauthorized use is considered hacking, or at the very least, illegal tampering. Bad USB is best used for cybersecurity, automation tasks, and ethical hacking. Use your powers for good. But if you want to write your own, you totally can, and I'm going to show you how right now. For my editor of choice, I personally like using Notepad++. It's just better than the regular Notepad, and it gets the job done efficiently. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and download Notepad++. Once we have Notepad++ downloaded, we're going to extract it, and then we're going to doll it. There we go. So here we have Notepad++. Now the next thing that we're going to need is the language, the DuckyScript language, which can be found at Uber Guido Z's GitHub here. And for whatever reason, when I did this a while ago, all of a sudden no one could find it. Nobody knew how to do it. So I've also posted it on the Modern Broadcast website, where you can get the DuckyScript download for free right here. But again, this comes directly from Uber Guido Z, so thank you so much. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. But yeah, and there's a link right here to go to the source. So, but completely free to download, where you'll get the XML file that we need in order to write Ducky Script. So I already have it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and go to languages, user defined language, and define your language. We're going to import. Here's the file right here. Here is me testing that it works on ModernBroadcast, but here's the file right here. So there we have it. Import successful. Say okay. We're going to save as. Saved as Ducky Script. Now we see down here we have Ducky Script language. We're going to go ahead and click on that. And we can write our own. Now let's try a safe example together. And let's go ahead and do delay. So a delay is basically going to wait 1,000 milliseconds. Then we want to type in GUIR, which is GUI is the Windows key, and then R is run, so those push together. Then we're going to delay again for half a second, and we want to string, notepad, enter. Delay again about another half a second. And string is basically, when we type in string, that means write this in a string. Like imagine all these things are connected by this string. So when we say string, we can put in however many things that we want. We can put in full sentences. Like what we're about to do is we're going to go and say hello and welcome to Modern Broadcasts. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Okay, and enter. So there we have it. I mean, that is a simple script. So breaking it down is delay 1,000, pauses the script for 1 second to let the PC kind of detect the flipper and make sure that everything's good to go. The GUIR is the Windows shortcut for the run command. So that's the Windows key plus the run key. Now string notepad literally types the word notepad, while enter presses the enter key on your keyboard. So Ducky Script language is very easy once you learn kind of what does what, but it's pretty plain language. You know, enter is the enter key and string is how you type sentences and how the keyboard does a whole list of commands. In less than 2 seconds, it's gonna launch this program. It's gonna type whatever we want. And now imagine using this to open up scripts or payloads, check IP settings, trigger automated tasks. It's really like a mini keyboard robot. So to save this to our flipper, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and save as. We'll put it on our desktop and we'll just type in message.txt. Okay, make sure to add .txt, otherwise it will not work, especially when the save type is all types. We could try to find that down in here and mess with all that, but just keep it as all types and type in .txt and go ahead and hit save. Back on our flipper zero, we have our message here. We're going to go ahead, drag this over, and drop it right in there. Now, making this full screen here, what we're going to do, if we click on this, and we scroll down to bad USB. Oh yeah, that's right. I can't show you on here, but if we were to do that, our MB message would be there. So let's go ahead. I'm going to unplug from the flipper, from Q flipper, and I'm just going to run it. There we go. And I just found our message. We're going to go and click on OK. And then when you click on it, it gives you an option to either run it, change the keyboard layout, and in the most updated firmware, the other one is to connect via Bluetooth. So Bluetooth is now just directly built into bad USB, where before you had to have a different firmware for that. So now baked right in is Bluetooth support or USB support. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm still connected via the USB cable, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit run, and we'll see it take effect. There it goes. I think I made a typing error. I forgot to type in and. I just said ND. But as we see, I mean, that was immediately fast. That was real time, not sped up. It typed all that quick. Now imagine what you could do if you start utilizing automation tasks. Get rid of bloatware off Windows, Mac, or you know, Linux, whatever. All the bloat can take care of that in seconds, maybe minutes, depending on the uninstall process. But, you know, running to get IP addresses or getting, you know, and then when you connect this to the internet, you'll be able to do a whole bunch of stuff. You can even have webhooks that send it to you via Discord message on whatever your payload is. You know, if you need the passwords from a Google account in the autosave feature, you can export that. There are scripts for that, but please, please, please use responsibly. Do not get yourself in trouble with a toy. It's not worth it. You know, always get permission before running on systems. I mean, that pretty much covers it and knocking that out. So let's go ahead and let's wrap this stuff up. Let's go ahead and head out to the outro. It's been bugging me for a while that I've been trying to sell you a shirt. I'm like, hey, go to Modern Broadcast TV, get yourself a shirt, get a hoodie, you know, yada, yada, yada. Why am I trying to sell you a shirt or a hoodie? That has nothing to do with what I do that has nothing to do with this channel, and it just feels very sales pitchy. I'm done with that. I don't want to do that. I wasn't enjoying it. I felt gross every time. I'm like, check out the shirt. I don't want to do it. So I've been talking with Mrs. Broadcast a lot on what can I do differently. Came up with this great idea. At least I think so. We'll see how it pans out. But to make memberships on the website. So as everyone knows, we do the video games monthly giveaways for free on Modern Broadcast TV. That's gonna stay. That will always be a thing, is that we will continue to do those giveaways for free for the Video Games Monthly. But I wanted to make a premium giveaway where we're doing higher tier games. You know, maybe, you know, we'll throw in Pokemon games in there, you know, things that wouldn't come in a subscription box, but make it exclusive for members only and keep it affordable. That's the other thing, is I want it to be highly affordable for you guys. So the beginner tier is at $2.99. $2.99 gets you entry into the members only giveaways. I think we're going to take a poll because this is the first time, so it's a learning curve for everyone. But I think we're going to maybe do a Switch game, or there's going to be a poll on the Discord where everyone can vote. So the $2.99 gets you in for the entry, to enter in the giveaway. I want it to be a value of like $50, and then with more members and more memberships, increase that, you know, make it $70. So that way it's like a brand new PS5 game. I think that'd be awesome. That's more related to what my channel is about. It's about tech. It's about gaming. It's about the flipper. You know, I don't think I can give away flipper, guys. I think that might have some consequences there. But, you know, so the $2.99, I'm rambling, and I'm going to have to cut this up, and this is going to be hopping all over the place. But I think that is the best way to do it. I'm not going to try to sell you a t-shirt, but I'm going to give you a t-shirt if you're subscribed, you know, so go that route. And that gets the Modern Broadcast brand out there, and you guys get a shirt, a hoodie, a mug, you know, whatever out of it, just for being a friend, being a buddy. And I think it's a better setup. So there's a $14.99 tier where I want to give away handhelds, you know, the handhelds that I review on the channel. I want to be able to do that, where, you know, this is the Retroid Pocket Mini with the cat hair on it, so I took that off. But anyways, the Retroid Pocket Mini, I want to do modded consoles. I want to work with Retro Repair Resale and say, hey, can I get, you know, a Game Boy Advance that's completely modded to the nines, has a backlit screen, looks beautiful, and can we work a deal out and do that? Do modded GameCubes. I have 8 GameCubes. I don't need 8 GameCubes, and most of them are modded. You know, do a giveaway of a modded GameCube and things like that. I'm excited about it. I'm passionate about that. I'm not passionate about trying to sell you a t-shirt or a mug. I don't give a shit. That's a real talk. I don't know how much of that's going to be in the video or how much of that's going to get cut out, but that's important to me and this channel. And I'm hoping that this generates enough buzz. And like I said, the more members that we get, the better the giveaways can be. You know, right now we're at zero, and so I'm going to be dipping into my own collection. You know, I'm going to be giving away stuff that I already have, so that way I can, you know, bring down the cost to me. So once we start building up those memberships to expand, and then, you know, maybe we go to level 7 games and we buy a holy grail of a game and something, you know, like Shining Force 3. That's one of mine. Whatever, you know, I would hate to give that away, but I would. So, but, you know, buy a holy grail and then put it in for the giveaway, because we would have the memberships to help support that and to help offset that. I want to do something that I care about, and I want to do something that makes me feel good. This is my outlet. And so let's make that happen. Let's make it happen, guys. So go to the Discord, go ahead and do a vote. It's going to be up today, because it actually was up yesterday. It's weird because this video comes out Sunday. Right now I'm recording Saturday. The poll's going to go up today, Saturday, but I'm going to keep it up through Sunday. And then basically Monday, we're going to post whatever it is. I'm going to come up with some stuff. I think I'm going to do a Switch game. I think I'm going to do a retro game. And then I think I'm going to do some sort of tech thing. So that way there's a variety there. And whatever has the most votes, that's what it's going to be. I'm also going to post it on the YouTube posting, so that way we can make this happen. So a lot of rambling, a lot of talking. So let's go ahead and wrap this up, huh? Now, this has been your crash course on bad USB. Let me know in the comment section down below, what do you want to see next? What's next for the Flipper Zero for beginners? Do we want to do the sub gigahertz? Do we want to do the IR blaster? Just get that knocked out, as I think that one's probably the most boring for people, but you know, maybe we'll mess with something. Or do we want to do the RFID? Let me know in the comment section down below what you want to see next on the Flipper Zero. And with enough people saying that they want to see it, that's what we'll do. So thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like and subscribe. I know I did a long tangent about ModernBroadcast.tv, but here's another one, ModernBroadcast.tv, for that new system. Get some free stuff, guys. Well, I shouldn't say free, because it is a subscription, it is a membership, so it's not free, but significantly reduced. Get some gear, get some tech, get some games on ModernBroadcast.tv. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great week, and take care.